Tentatively on Wednesday the 8th, Correctionville will be playing. Sports team. So that will be at the high school from 4:30. It starts at 4:30 and should be over by 6:30 at the latest. So are there any other announcements? Well, let's prepare for
my God, my Today is the first Sunday of the Christian season of Advent. The word Advent comes from the Latin Adventus, which means coming. The entire season is the spiritual preparation for the physical and spiritual arrival of Jesus. Joseph is commanded to give the child born to Mary the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. This name literally means the Lord saves. So on this day, we let
simply Christmas.
What joy do we have to share today? church is decorated for Christmas?
Yes. We didn't get to do this last year. I was thinking about that when they're saying, we went through this last year, not
this year. Again, so.
More joy.
We had a wonderful Thanksgiving. We celebrated ours yesterday. And it was really good. It turned out really well.
More joys. That was another wonderful thing.
Getting to celebrate Thanksgiving together.
More joys to share. Well, let's celebrate our joy by lifting up our offering.
Had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you will name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the Lord, angel of the Lord commanded him. He took his wife, took her as his wife. The word of God for the people of God. Amen.
Our first hymn is hymn, this
is hymn number 196, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus. Joshua or Hosea, which are forms of Yeshua, It was unexpected. And it rose the whole idea of who salvation was for. Instead of just Jewish people, as Yeshua literally means God is salvation, Jesus or Isu in Greek meant God is salvation for Jews and Gentiles.
Not only was
Jesus' name meant to turn the idea of hope to save Messiah was for, Jesus would change what it means to be a king.
His previous name
was Joshua and Hosea. Joshua was the successor of Moses, and he was associated with conquering because he was the conquered.
He conquered the people
in Palestine to create Israel. The prophet Hosea comes to mean being committed to the unfaithful because of his wife and all of the trials and troubles he went through bringing his wife back all those times. As a Messiah, the Jewish people were expecting a conqueror committed to the people despite their unfaithfulness of the people. Someone who was going to save them from the Roman occupiers and restore a lost people to the rightful place as the most important nation in the ancient world.
But the salvation he
had for them was not a physical saving, but one of a spiritual nature. And God literally turned the idea of Messiah completely on its head. No longer was salvation just coming to the Jewish people. Salvation was coming to all peoples. Christmas itself can have the same effect. We all have an idea what the perfect Christmas shall be, or will be. We imagine sitting by a roaring fire in front of a fireplace, a beautifully decorated full Christmas tree, surrounded by presents and family members sitting around telling stories and singing. More often than not, though, we get caught up in attempting to make the perfect Christmas. Our quest looks more like a scene from The Grinch. You know, scrambling around, buying presents, making sure our houses are fully lighted. And if you remember what became the total focus of the news, they had completely lost the concept of what Christmas was. It would take the Grinch to upend their celebration and return the focus back to Christmas.
And at the same time,
it would completely turn upside down the Grinch's understanding of Christmas as well. What he and the citizens of Louisville all would discover is that simply Christmas is Christmas simply.
Nothing fancy.
Nothing ornate or ostentatious. Just simply Christmas.
And this makes me
ask these questions of you. So what does salvation mean to you? What are your expectations of what salvation looks like?
Does the thought of
being saved give you hope?
Think about that word
salvation for a moment. Saved from what? Death. The appeal and the attraction of our faith is we speak to people about life. If a person wants to live, really live, he or she must come to know the Savior, the giver of life. For me, salvation simply means God cancels the past. He cancels all our past screw-ups, all those moments of unfaithfulness. God takes all those things, wipes the slate clean, and starts over again.
To put this another way,
through salvation, we are given the opportunity to change our trajectory of our lives.
In other words,
our lives are not really turned upside down, because we are already upside down.
Salvation
turns our lives right side up.
Christmas is a testimony.
That God was born, and because even being born in a religious family is not enough to restore your broken relationship with God.
We must have
a Savior. Christmas is a reminder that salvation is a supernatural work of God, meant to turn our lives right side up. The work of the supernatural, again, is meant to turn us right side up. See, when Gabriel announced to Joseph that he would, that Mary would, could be giving birth to the Savior of all humankind, God came to reverse our course.
To bring out the...
bring out of being lost to being found.
And this is what simply Christmas is really about. Celebrating God
for giving us the opportunity to start over.
The opportunity to
truly focus on Jesus as our salvation. Over these next 5 weeks, we're going to experience Christmas in more ways than you can possibly thought of. We will be talking about how Jesus is God with us, what our faith response to Jesus as Christmas,
how
we become a part of the story, and how finding our King will set us free. So as we leave here today, remember that Jesus is salvation simply.
Remember to not
let the rush and stress of Advent get the best of you. And simply remember to live out Christmas simply.
Well, what concerns do we
have to lift up today?
Kathy Joy.
Kathy Joyce.
Joy.
More concerns? Let me continue
to look at Leonard Todd.
More concerns? All those traveling today,
we were still on our way home.
Well, let us pray.
Gracious and Heavenly Father,
we thank you for
all the blessings we received, for family being able to get together this
past week to celebrate Thanksgiving, for being able to decorate
the church here at Cushing,
unlike we were,
and able to last year even have service here on the Advent.
For the gift of salvation you have
given us.
And as we celebrate these joys,
we also lift up our concerns. Be with Kathy Joy.
Be with Leonard Todd.
Be with all those who are traveling to get home today.
This we ask
your Son and our Savior Jesus Christ. Now we pray as Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Let us close with
hymn number 251, Go Tell It On Out. Thank you.
as the return of Jesus is also very exciting. While we are waiting, help our families to show and share your love to all people. Amen.